So the other day we took out the new Sony A7S with the Movi M5 to shoot a little bit of low light. Obviously that's one of the first benefits of this camera system is that it performs pretty unparalleled in low light. You can crank up the ISO pretty high. The benefit of that is that you can, in low light conditions, get a lens within its comfort zone, so it's resolving a clean image. ISO is a little bit inaccessible, but you can see how far we can actually crank it. So 409,600 ISO, which, just looking at the screen, you don't see a ton of noise already. It stays, I mean, really pretty clean compared to other cameras. So I'm looking forward to putting this up against 5Ds and C100s and such. But also the other benefit of its low light performance is that you can also kind of have more control over your depth of field. So in the video, we kind of used really shallow depth of field to kind of show the character isolating herself and her technology. And then we opened up that depth of field when things became a little bit more frightening and she had to kind of pay attention to more to her surroundings. Another great thing about this camera is that you can shoot in S-Log 2. We haven't put this up to a chart, but it looks like it's getting dynamic range pretty close to being on par with the F55 and F5, so somewhere around 13 to 14 stops, which gives you a lot of flexibility in post. We're using cine lenses with this A7S. This is a full-frame camera, and we're using a Metabones adapter, which was actually vignetting the chip. So what we were able to do with one of the functions of this camera was center crop to an APS-C size sensor, which allowed us to use those lenses without any of the vignetting of the adapter. The benefit of pretty much all DSLRs, and this one included, is it's a small body, makes it easy to mount on systems like the M5 or even drones. But with the internal record options, low light capabilities, and S-Log 2, you can really get a lot more out of your image with a system like this. Another benefit that we didn't really play with was high speed options, and obviously a lot of the big marketing around this camera at NAB was that you could use it with an Atomos recorder to actually record 4K externally. So we're looking forward to playing with those options and seeing what this camera has to offer.